Hold that thought. Reeve and Amberin, you arrive and there is a commotion happening at what appears to be the Half Moon Tavern, which is to your north. There is a inn to your south, which is presumably where you'll be staying tonight.
Well, I haven't had my alcohol yet, so we're going to go up to the tavern up here.
What about you, Amberin?
Where am I? Oh, there I am. Okay. Yeah, no, here we go.
He's all supposed to turn around and be like, come on, honey.
All right.
No.
There is a raucous party happening in one corner of the bar. Everyone is gathered around a banquet table. There is a very rich, formally dressed man and woman sharing a feast with the rest of the tavern, which come from all walks of life. And in the midst of it all, Quinn and Buckthorn sit while Vod at the top at the bar is just kind of with his hand over his eyes, like wanting absolutely nothing to do.
I want to go over and sit next to the woman.
I'm going to go to Vod.
That's the man.
I'm sitting next to the woman.
I want to go sit next to the woman.
Okay.
And I want to sit down and be like, well, you guys are having fun. I'll put over at Quinn and be like, Quinn, my man.
Oh, you commoners are a riot. We're just having a glorious anniversary.
Me and Reggie here. Reggie were about to do another shot.
Yes.
You want to join us?
It's lovely to see how the 99% spend their lives. It's just lovely.
It's fun, isn't it, Sam? You guys are having a lot of fun, and I want to turn to the woman and be like, she looks a little ill, though. Do you need to head to the bathroom? Do you need some help?
Oh, my God.
I've got her. Not me and her husband, Reggie. We're taking good care of her.
I feel fine.
How about
we take care of you? And I want to try to, like, help her to the bathroom.
All right, all right, guys. You can't do this. All right.
There wasn't a seat on both sides of
her. I just wanted to piss
her off. She was on one side. I was on the other side.
Okay, you can both support her weight, I guess.
Sounds good.
All right. Oh, yes. Get it better out than in, I always say, honey.
Oh, yes.
All right. We'll take her over to the bathroom over here, I guess.
All right.
And
all right.
Don't worry, it's nothing creepy.
All right.
And let's, like, open the door and put her in a little bit. And then I want to check how aware is she right now?
She's drunk, but not like blackout drunk.
Okay, so while
most
I'm just kind of like
in the bar are drunk, but not blackout drunk.
While I'm mostly carrying her over, can I try to pick her pockets?
Yes, she's carrying a small spaghetti string purse.
It would be so
easy to just snap it and take the gold. Oh, what a shame! The snap just came undone and fell right into your leather pouch. Endurance check.
Oh no.
Oh my god!
Why are you ruining this for me? I was so gonna score.
She's dead.
Do I end it here?
No, we got time. We got plenty of time.
Do I end it here?
Keep going, Luke. It's our first session. Keep going. Come on.
Yeah, an hour and 15 minutes.
I was about to say, this is a pretty good cliffhanger. All right, Reeve, your shadow arm comes completely unfurled from the gaping hole in your bandages and begins to strangle the woman against the bar, the wall of the bathroom.
Yeah, but did I get the gold?
Yeah, you still got the gold.
How much?
Actually, hold on. Let me get to my treasure. I didn't think you guys would get treasure so soon.
Some real priority here.
Yeah. Sorry. I have to get to the character builder. One sec.
That's right.
This is cool. It's cool. She is carrying with her. She's carrying with her 150 gold.
Wow. She considers herself rich.
Well, she's also got. She also has in her purse a diamond necklace and diamond bracelet, which you can hawk for money.
Diamond. What? It was diamond bracelet and a diamond what else?
Diamond necklace. They will sell for more as part of a set.
Sounds good.
All right.
I'm joking her.
Okay, so Amryn.
Not the good way, apparently.
Yeah, not the good way. This is the bad way.
Wait, did Quinn go with him?
Yeah.
No, I decided not to, actually.
Oh, okay, cool. Buckthorn, however, is with Reeve as this happens.
Ma'am, you seem to have dropped some of your belongings.
Wow.
Hey, I want to turn to Buckthorn and be like, here's your ID back if you need that.
Oh, okay. God.
Thank you. I'm glad you found a computer so quickly.
I did. Could you help free her here?
What do I need to do?
Okay.
Oh, right.
Did you have something to say, Luke, or were you?
No, nothing happens. She can't breathe, and no one has noticed yet. Against all odds, no one has noticed this.
I'll say, Buckthorn, just knock my arm off her, or try to free her, please. If you could push her away from me, my grab will also.
Okay, yeah, I'll.
But don't hurt her though. Do non-lethal or something.
Okay. Yeah.
You can just try to bull rush her.
I'll like slam his arm with one of my two shields.
Okay, give me an attack roll on that.
You can bull rush me, yeah.
Nice. Yes, you pin the shadowy arm against the wall. It releases its grip on the woman. She falls to the ground unconscious with a loud thud. Quinn, you notice that Reginald hears this over the clamor of the party and now seems concerned.
Reggie, more shots, come on.
Reggie, I like how you've shortened his name. Yes, you pour out the last two shots in the bottle. And for now, he seems to be placated?
Placated.
Okay, yeah. However, he keeps glancing over at the bathroom. Meanwhile, Amryn and Vod, what is happening?
Do we hear that?
Yes. In fact, Vod, you turn around and actually see all of this happen. Everyone else in the party is partying, looking at the party.
Right.
And then the muse guy is too busy, like, looking at the piano and playing the piano.
I will look over at Amryn and tell her, I think it's time for us to leave.
Yeah, we should go. How do we cover... Oh, God, this is so bad.
I want to shut the bathroom door.
We're going to just walk out.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I'm just going to walk with them, too. I'm just going to keep going.
No.
I'm going to shout over at Reginald. I'm just going to be like, she's really barfing up a storm in there if you want to help her out, but she might be okay.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Reginald... Quinn, Reginald stumbles past you towards the bathroom.
Wait! Oh, damn it!
I'll follow a bit of a distance behind Reeve and yell to Reginald, farewell, friend. I hope your wife ends up all right.
Reeve!
Oh, my God. Why Reeve, would you
what did
say
you do?
That?
Well, because she's passing out from being drunk. Yeah. Makes sense.
Unless he notices the indentation of fingerprints around her neck.
Do I see? Do I see everybody else leaving?
Yes, you do.
I will go back inside.
I'm gonna stay with Vi. Stay with Vi.
I'm going to the inn.
The guards.
Stop ignoring me.
The guards don't seem to think anything unusual is happening.
Good, because it hasn't.
I'm going to go back in and pretend like I left something over at the table and just kind of work my way and kind of keep an eye over there while everything's
okay.
Happening.
Okay. You look as Reginald opens the door in shock to see his passed out wife. And he exclaims, you guys are getting so fucking lucky right now.
Well, he's drunk.
She's just had a little too much. Oh, it's time to call it a night, I believe. One
sure
more
is.
Round for everyone on the house.
Yeah. It's a good thing he's drunk.
Yeah, he's fairly drunk. That was good. Quinn, you get one warp shard for initiating a party in the inn.
Nice.
That is That is the meta currency of the campaign. You can exchange it for items later on. So you have one warp shard. Roxy, also you get one warp shard for gaining access to a potential revenge plot.
Okay.
Yeah. Amarin, you get a warp shard for being pregnant. Just kidding.
Oh, God.
All right. Who's going to the inn? Buckthorn. We got Buckthorn, we got Quinn, and we got Reeve. All right, you enter what appears to be the lowest level of the inn, which looks kind of like a hostel. Like, it's got kind of, like, people's clothes strewn about. It doesn't look very fancy.
Oh, but before I like, walk into line of sight and bright light, I want to try to wrap my arm up again before him.
Oh, yes. Give me a streetwise check. You're hiding it pretty well under your cloak, but the second you stop moving, like, it'll start wiggling and shit again.
Yeah. It's kind of wrapped, I suppose.
Okay. you managed to at least tie your arm to your shoulder so it's not reaching out of your cloak or dragging behind you. But it's, like, really, like, fidgety.
Okay.
All right. And I guess you're all approaching the innkeeper here?
Yeah.
There's a little name tag. It says Zyrella Blackleaf on the name tag. It's a very pale-skinned elf with raven black hair filing her nails and doesn't really acknowledge your approach.
VIP suite, please. We are the presidential suite.
What? Oh, right. Right, whatever. How many keys do you need?
We need 7 keys.
7 keys? We only have 6.
I'll take 6 is fine. We'll have I point over to Buckthorn. I'm like, he'll just follow me.
Okay. Yeah, if you swing that way it's fine. I don't really care though. Like she leans in, you see that she either has really strong eyeliner under her eyes or she hasn't slept in a while. And puts the 6 keys for the VIP suite in front of you.
Can I do an insight check to see why that might be?
Yes.
Because I don't really know how to trust this person. Let's see. Oh, wow. I got tons of insight. Boom.
Wow. Wow. Fucking wow. Pretty gothy.
Man.
Maybe she likes
the style around here, I guess.
Yeah, apparently. Yeah, okay, so she's just filing her nails, painted black, of course, and hands you the 6 keys to the VIP suite.
I'll hand one to Quinn and one to Buck, or I won't hand one to Buckthorn. I'll wait until we walk up here.
Oh my God,
I don't give a shit, Bailey. Like, there's, like, things I don't give a shit about. So there's, like, there's, like, 401k, there's AIDS in Africa. And then way down here is when girls file their nails. That's okay. Go ahead.
I want to go over towards the stairs and just kind of wait for any side of my party members coming in. Mm. I also still don't know that it's clear from the bar, so I'm also keeping an eye out for guards running in to just kind of slip around the corner.
Right, sure. Insight, Quinn. She hasn't slept in a while, appears to be sleep-deprived. You're also getting a distinct impression that she may be a creature of the night, although you are not sure what manner.
She could be a revenant,
she could be a vampire. Could be
a prostitute!
Not a woman of the night, a creature of the night.
Well, hey, I don't discriminate based on gender.
Okay, all right. Wow, okay, all right. She could be a revenant. She could be, like, part revenant, part Vryloka, part vampire. You're not sure.
So, seeing her, I completely forget about Samantha.
Oh, yeah. Fuck that bitch, right?
So, you been here long? Working here?
Yeah, my stupid dad making me work here 5 years ago.
Oh, that's the worst. Don't you hate parents?
Yeah, I do. She looks like a 25-ish age.
Perfect.
15.
All right. Yeah. give me a diplomacy check. This is the rapiest episode I think we've ever had.
Whoa, I only rob people. He's crazy.
That's 23?
Yeah. Pretty good.
She seems to, you know, think you're a little bit more interesting than other tenants of the inn. But she's still pretty guarded.
So, I don't know, this place seems kind of boring. What do you do for fun around here?
Drink and read.
I like drinking.
That's pretty much all there is to do, unless you're some kind of fag that likes nature walks.
Fuck nature walks. Oh my god. Those pussies over in the farmer's market, no meat? Come on.
I know, right?
So, maybe when do you...
You're lucky she eats meat, or she would have been extremely offended by that.
I took the roll of dice, you know.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm looking to, you know, I'm not looking to turn in like the rest of my party. They're all losers, you know, so maybe you want to get a drink or something when you get off your shift.
I get off at 8 o'clock tomorrow. I do the night shift.
You can't get out, you know, seems like you guys might have some nice nights here. Maybe take a walk, grab a couple beers, you know. Do you have a break?
I prefer wine. I can't take a break. I have to guard the till in case we get any late check-ins.
I'm sure it'll be fine. You could walk away for a little bit.
Charisma-based check for me. Any and all, except for intimidate.
Fuck.
Except for the one he probably has.
Exactly.
Well, it's also you're not being intimidating.
Yeah,
swooning.
No.
You're trying to make her swoon.
I guess diplomacy.
I guess.
I guess. Oh,
you know okay. What? Screw my dad and screw this place. Yeah, sure. Why not? Around midnight. Cool. We'll go grab a drink.
Yes. It's yes. This is going to happen.
Well, Quinn's dead.
This is Quinn is
like
dead.
A combination between the social Roxy and like the creepy Ree put together.
Yeah. Right. So, it's like it's a terrible. Awful of things that is going to get you guys in trouble eventually.
Can I hear this is going on from up here?
Yeah, sure. You're still waiting over there.
I just want to kind of like walk down a little bit. And I just
god
be
damn
like,
it, Reeve. You're such a cock block. Oh, my God.
I just want to go, okay, if you guys are going for any really good drinks or meat or blood or something, I don't know, any of those kind of cool drinks, just let me know. I turn to Quinn and I'm like, I'm not gonna get in your way, but man, I do some. She just looks tasty. I don't know why. And I just walk away, like really creepily, with no explanation.
Oh my god, he's a vampire! Like he wants blood. Oh my god.
Well, Reeve doesn't know he's really a vampire yet.
What's her name again?
Hold on, I can actually make the nameplate show up. One second.
I can see it. Oh, it's Zarella Blackleaf.
It's just really small.
Oh, yeah.
I can
yeah.
zoom in more.
Yeah, so there's a sidebar. Like, you can zoom in and out on the right side.
Top right, yeah.
Top right.
Okay, yeah. Got it, yep. So, Zarella, don't worry about him.
He seems like kind of a loser.
He is, right?
I can totally still hear you guys.
No. She said it quietly so you wouldn't hear it. She's
yeah,
not...
we're like really close. So, yeah, don't worry about him.
We're like really close. We just met like 5 minutes ago, you know.
I met in proximity, like of.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Like we're talking close.
Yeah, right.
Don't worry about him. Me and you are just gonna go, just hang out, have some fun, you know, just real quick, you know, have a couple drinks, you know. All right.
She seems kind of creeped out by how you said that last statement. They'd be like. Look, yeah, drinks. We'll go get drinks. That's it.
Yeah. You know what? I'm gonna go up to the room. I'll see you around midnight then.
You guys are like the video, The Creep by Lonely Island. You're just like creeping up on women. All right. Is everyone going upstairs?
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for everyone so I can hand out the keys.
Okay. Vod and Amryn, what's up?
I'm going to take Amryn by the arm and very slowly start walking outside with her.
Okay.
And as we walk, I'm going to turn towards her and be like, what do I want to say? Is there a particular reason you don't trust me?
Ooh, serious talk.
Oh, wait. No, Amryn doesn't not trust Roxy. She doesn't not trust... No, Amryn... Okay. I don't trust Reeve. I trust you. You've gotten better. You're not much help, but I do trust you. It's hard because I don't trust Reeve. It's difficult. He's difficult. And the other two, I don't know where they come from, so...
I just want you to know that I'm being honest with you, so I need you to be honest with me. How much of a Charles situation are we looking at here? Be honest.
Oh, sorry, Vod, in reference to who?
Reeve's arm, Reeve? I suppose.
When you cut off the arm, well, that's going to be hard. There's got to be a different way, though, because it's like a curse. We can easily, not easily, but we can probably get rid of the curse.
Both of you make religion checks for me.
Okay.
I mean, take into account, Amryn already got that 20.
Oh, that's not bad. It's not bad.
Yeah, I am taking that into account. This is different.
I shrug.
Amryn, if you could somehow cause Reeve's spirit, the ghosty arm, not the swindler gambler, somehow make Reeve's spirit come to terms with his new predicament and feel like his family's legacy is secured, perhaps he can at least rest in peace with his new lot in life. Reeve's arm.
Okay.
You're telling
me. I relayed that to Vi.
Okay, okay. So I can trust that you'll take care of that, correct?
Why do I always have to take care of it? That is the problem.
I like how it's like subtly hinting, like, it's going to get taken care of, right?
Like, you're the captain of the ship.
We're not going to have to worry about the problem anymore, are we?
I keep walking along with her, and I say, can I ask, how old are you, Amryn?
Probably in my 60s now, 50s. Ooh.
Why she doesn't look it.
Why do you look so good to be so old?
Didn't we talk about this?
We were locked up one time.
You bit me, Roxy, you bit me. Because I didn't age, you're like, well, I'm a vampire. Remember?
Did we talk about that?
Yeah, back when we got captured.
That's okay. Yeah. Vod doesn't know.
It was like
it's cool.
Okay, yeah. We can talk about it again just for a refresher.
Yeah. So you did share that you don't age.
Yes.
Well, okay. I need to teach you a few things about life experience. Follow me. I want you to watch what I do.
This is like a Rocky Horror Picture Show situation. He's about to lead her to like a veiled bed.
We're going to
I have both pods.
We're gonna enter into the end here. I would assume we're probably close.
Yeah, you are.
Oh, okay.
It's like 20 feet away.
So we'll go inside and we'll go up to the the front desk.
Mm-hmm. You see Reeve.
Yeah,
you see Reeve, Buckthorn, and Quinn standing in the corner. There, Reeve is holding a bunch of keys.
Okay. I guess. I'll keep leading her over here, up to the front desk, and I'll extend a hand and greet Zarella. Hello, Zarella. My name is Zod.
Hi. What can I do for you?
Zarella, is there a man bothering you that wears a hat?
What? Hat? I ain't seen anybody like that. I don't know what you're talking about.
You've never seen...
Are you checking in or what?
No, we're with the party over there. I'm simply asking if anyone's giving you trouble.
Trouble? No, not aside from the guy with the weird bulge in his cloak going on with his arm.
Look at my bulge. Oh,
Zod will slowly look over at Amryn.
Well, yeah, he always gives people trouble regardless of, you know,
that's,
his arm.
That's true.
We need to form a plan, Amryn. How are we going to do what you say?
I just wanted to come get a flower. there's no rituals, I guess, that would...
You were just told you just gotta help me.
You bought rituals?
Inheritance.
Yeah.
That's not what I said, Reeves.
You just gotta help me get my money.
We have to find a way to calm spirit, make him go away in peace or something like that.
He's gonna be a part of Reeve forever.
Right.
But
to calm him,
if he
right?
can come to terms with that.
There you go, come to terms.
You're the one who accompanied him to the manor. I assume that you are the one who will go there at some further time.
Do I have to go back? Oh my god.
You just mentioned that you need that soul to be at rest. I'm going to count on you to get that done, as you are the captain.
He's going back to steal his mom's, like this lady's money.
I don't think he is, because you're going with him.
Oh.
Roxy.
I'm sorry, who was that?
Vod, I'm sorry, Vod. How about, since you're so good at convincing people how to do things, you just disguise yourself as me and talk to Reeve?
I don't think so.
Then it's probably not going to happen, because I can't guarantee you that I'm that good at talking people, especially Reeve, out of things.
Well, then we're going to have a major problem on it.
We already do.
Reeve's getting a little impatient and yells over, "Hey, honey, I have the keys here."
Your husband's calling you.
She's going to just blankly stare at Vod, like, she's not laughing. She's not laughing.
You need to get rest for the child.
You need to get rest for the child, Amryn.
You have a child?
Quinn yells over the room.
This is why you're 50-50 with me, Roxy.
I don't know who that is. I'm sorry.
I mean, that's out of my character. I mean Vod. I'm sorry. I keep on messing up out of character because I don't remember.
We're assuming you're saying Vod.
Yeah, please.
I had the same trouble.
Change your damn name. Change it to Vod on this thing.
How do I do that? Name, Roxy.
Oh, I can go and change that, though. I can go and
Yeah, that's all I need. And, well,